Hello and welcome to the session. In this session, we discuss the following question which says, find the sum of the series 2 plus 5x plus 8x squared plus 11x cubed plus and so on to n terms. Hence, write down the sum to infinity when x less than 1 numerically. First of all, let's see what is an arithmetical geometric series . The general or standard form of such a series is given by a plus tb whole into r plus a plus 2d whole into r square plus a plus 3d whole into r cube plus and so on plus a plus n minus 1 whole into d and this whole into r to the power n minus 1 plus and so on. This is an arithmetical geometric series, each term of which is found by multiplying the corresponding terms of an AP and a GP. And in this case, the AP is a plus d plus a plus 2d plus a plus 3d plus and so on plus a plus n minus 1 into d plus and so on. And here the GP, that is the geometric progression, is 1 plus r plus r square plus r cube plus and so on plus r to the power n minus 1 plus and so on. This is the key idea that we use in this question. Let's now move on to the solution. We are supposed to find the sum of this series to n terms. And also, we have to write down the sum to infinity of this series when x less than 1 numerically. Now, the given series is 2 plus 5x plus 8x square plus 11x cube plus and so on. Now, this series is formed by multiplying the terms of the AP, which is 2 plus 5 plus 8 plus 11 plus and so on, and the GP, which is 1 plus x square plus x cube plus and so on. So each term of this arithmetical geometric series is found by multiplying the corresponding terms of the AP and GP. Now this series is arithmetical geometric series. Now the nth term of the given arithmetical geometric series is given by 2 plus n minus 1 the whole into 3 and this whole multiplied by x to the power n minus 1. And this is equal to 3n minus 1 and this whole into x to the power n minus 1. This is the nth term of the given arithmetical geometric series. Now we suppose let Sn be equal to 2 plus 5x plus 8x square plus 11x cube plus and so on plus 3n minus 1 and this whole into x to the power n minus 1. Now for this geometric series, the common ratio is x. So now multiplying both sides by x, we get x into Sn is equal to 2 into x would be 2x plus 5x into x is 5x square plus 8x square into x is 8x cube plus and so on the n minus 1th term of Sn, which would be 3n minus 4 into x to the power n minus 2, and this into x would be equal to 3n minus 4 and this whole into x to the power n minus 1. So here we have 3n minus 4 whole into x to the power n minus 1, and this nth term multiplied by x give us 3n minus 1 the whole into x to the power n. Now next, subtracting these two, that is Sn and xSn, we get 1 minus x, this whole into Sn is equal to 2 plus 5x minus 2x gives us 3x, 8x square minus 5x square gives us 3x square plus 11x cube minus 8x cube gives us 3x cube plus and so on plus, now this 3n minus 1 into x to the power n minus 1 minus 3n minus 4, this whole into x to the power n minus 1, and this is equal to 3n minus 1 minus 3n plus 4, and this whole into x to the power n minus 1, which is equal to 3 into x to the power n minus 1. So here we have plus 3 into x to the power n minus 1, and this minus 3n minus 1 the whole into x to the power n. Now as you can see, this is a geometric series. Now we'll find out the sum of this geometric series, that is 3x plus 3x square plus 3x cube plus and so on plus 3 into x to the power n minus 1. And the sum of this geometric series is equal to the first term, which is 3x into 1 minus r to the power n, where r is the common ratio, that is x. So x to the power n minus 1, since in this series we have n minus 1 terms, and this whole upon 1 minus x. So this means we have 1 minus x the whole into Sn is equal to 2 plus 3x into 1 minus x to the power n minus 1 and this whole upon 1 minus x minus 3n minus 1 whole into x to the power n. That is Sn is equal to 2 upon 1 minus x plus 3x into 1 minus x to the power n minus 1 and this whole upon 1 minus x square minus 3n minus 1 whole into x to the power n and this whole upon 1 minus x. So this is the sum of the series to n terms. Thus we can say sum of the series to n terms is equal to 2 upon 1 minus x plus 3x into 1 minus x to the power n minus 1 and this whole upon 1 minus x square minus 3n minus 1 this whole into x to the power n and this whole upon 1 minus x. Now next we will find out the sum of the series to infinity. Now we know that if this common ratio x is less than 1, then as n tends to infinity, x raised to the power n minus 1 tends to 0 and x raised to the power n also tends to 0. Now, S infinity is the sum of the series to infinity, and this would be equal to limit n tends to infinity 2 upon 1 minus x plus 3x into 1 minus x to the power n minus 1 the whole, and this whole upon 1 minus x the whole square minus 3n minus 1 this whole into x to the power n and this whole upon 1 minus x. Now as limit n tends to infinity and x is less than 1, so this x to the power n minus 1 would be 0 and x to the power n would also be 0. So we get this is equal to 2 upon 1 minus x plus 3x into 1 minus 0 the whole upon 1 minus x the whole square minus 3n minus 1 upon 1 minus x into 0. Or you can say this is equal to 2 upon 1 minus x plus 3x upon 1 minus x the whole square. And this term is obviously 0. So this is S infinity, that is sum of the series to infinity is equal to 2 upon 1 minus x plus 3x upon 1 minus x the whole square. So this is the answer for the sum of the series to infinity, and this is the answer for sum of the series to n terms. So, this completes the session. Hope you have understood the solution of this question.